Hello everyone. My name is Dr. Dhwanitsa. Today my topic of presentation is tremor. Today we learn about tremors. So I think everyone know about the tremor something. It is a involuntary movement, sometimes symmetrical, sometimes asymmetrical, sometimes low frequency, sometimes high frequency, sometimes low amplitude, sometimes high amplitude. It is associated with many of the neurological conditions. So you have to go through the details about a tremor to identify which type of tremor, because all the types of tremor having the different type of treatment. So there are so many different type of causes of the tremor, and there are so many different types of tremor also. So we will learn in this lecture what are types of tremor, and how to identify, how to test it, and what are treatment for that, and how to differentiate diagnosis of all the tremors. So these are my contents of the today's lecture. We go to the definition, then the classification, common tremor syndromes, then diagnosis, and finally the treatment. So this is a definition. There's a tremor. The most common form of the abnormal involuntary movement, that in short you can remember AIM, abnormal involuntary movement, is a rhythmic oscillation of the body region produced by the alternating contraction of reciprocally inverted muscles. Right? It may involve both the sides of muscles, right? Agonist, antagonist as well. So the classification of tremors. First is the resting tremor, second is the action tremors. If it is action tremor, it may be postural tremor, kinetic tremors, or the intention tremor. Right? If it is resting tremor, then the clinical features mostly occurs when the body part is supported against gravity and not engaged in the activity. There are examples for that. It is seen in the Parkinson's disease, drug-induced Parkinsonism, multiple system atrophy, even in the progressive supranuclear palsy. If it is action tremor, it occurs with the voluntary contraction of the muscles. The next is the postural tremor. In the action tremor, we have the postural tremor, kinetic tremor, and intention tremor. So, in the postural tremor occurs when the body part is maintained against gravity. Examples such as the patient holds a newspaper or any glass of the water or any weight in the hand up to, above against the gravity. Then this type of tremor is seen. It is called postural tremor. The second is a kinetic tremor. It is most commonly occurred during voluntary movement. A kinetic tremor can occur at the beginning of the movement, during the course of the movement. Starting or during the course. It's seen in both the types. Third is the intention tremor. It occurs towards the end of a goal-directed movement. When we are reaching to the goal, at that time it starts in the last degrees of the end of the movement. It's commonly seen in the cerebellar type of lesions. That we've seen in my previous lecture of the cerebellum. So what are common tremor syndromes? Cerebellar tremor, essential tremor, psychogenic tremor, Parkinsonian tremor, and the physiologic tremor. So for identify all these tremors, we will go each types in detail. First is the cerebellar tremor. So in this you can find the slow tremor of the extremity that occurs at the end of a purposeful movement. When the movement is performed, but when you're reaching to the target, it has this type of tremor. It may go up or it may go down. Like if we have to do the finger to nose test. So the finger is not reaching to the nose, it's going either above the nose or going below the nose. This target is not going to fulfill. This happens because of the ipsilateral cerebellar lesion. For that, diagnosis will be done by brain CT scan or the brain MRI. Treatment is deep brain stimulation or medical treatment by tablet isoniazid. Second is the physiological tremor. It's most commonly found in low amplitude but high frequency tremor at the rest and during the action. It is enhanced by any type of stress, anxiety, or physical exhaustion, hypoglycemia, fever, alcohol withdrawal suddenly, or certain medications also can lead to this physiological tremor. So to diagnose this tremor, you must have to go through serum glucose level, thyroid stimulating hormone level, liver function testing, patient history to evaluate for the anxiety. Is there any incidence was happened or patient is going for any exam or any situation of the patients like that? or alcohol or the caffeine use that can also lead to this type of physiological tremor. So treatment will be according to the cause, according to the test result. We have to underline what are the cause of that particular tremor. We have to solve that. Right. Third type is essential tremor. So what is essential tremor? Essential tremor is most commonly you can find over here. It is symmetric, involves the hand, wrist, even the lower extremity, head, or the voice. Even positive family history also is present. Improvement with the alcohol. It is present with the variety of the task you do in daily activities. Also, it interrupts with your ADL activities. For this tremor to diagnose, we need to do the complete CBC, thyroid stimulating hormone level, serum chemistry profile to rule out the other disease also if it's associated with this. A treatment will be primidone, propranolol, or deep brain stimulation. Right? So pre-treatment hydrating test will be done. So in that you find this type of activity, then you must think about this essential tremor. Fourth one, very common one, that is about Parkinsonian tremor. Okay, you must have seen in the Parkinson type of patient. It begins with the low frequency pill rolling movement of the finger. Okay, like this. It is a resting tremor, asymmetric, involves the distal extremities. Okay, and decreases with the voluntary movement. When the patient is doing the movement, the tremor will reduce. When it is under rest, the tremor increases. For that to identify, we need to do the PET. Or the single photon emission, computerized tomography, MRI for the atypical presentation. A treatment may be dopamine agonist, anticholinergics, or deep brain stimulation. Okay, you find here in the pin rolling movement, the persistent tremor, okay, a shuffling gait, and taking the small steps. Okay, these are features of Parkinson. There you find this type of pin rolling tremor. Fifth one is a psychogenic tremor, or it's called hysterical tremor. Okay, it is a sudden onset and remission, increased incidence with the stress, and decrease when the patient is distracted. Okay, so it is change in a tremor direction also. It changes in the directions continuously. You cannot judge to the one direction. In this diagnosis, very, very careful history of the patient to be taken, because the reason is psychological. It may be associated with the stress. Okay, when the patient out of the stress, the tremor reduces. Treatment, we need to do counseling by the mental health counselor. Okay. Sixth one is a orthostatic tremor. It is very rare type of tremor. Okay, it is identified by the fast rhythmic muscle contraction that occur in the legs and the trunk immediately after the standing. So when the patient starts standing, so you can find this type of shaking movement in the knee or above knee muscles. Cramps are felt in the thigh and the legs. Patient may shake uncontrollably when asked to stand. When patient is walking, then no tremors will be felt or no tremor will be seen. But when the patient is standing steady in the one place, you find this type of tremors happens to one or both the legs. Right? That is called shaky legs. Okay, that is called orthostatic tremor. This is a very rare one. This seventh is the very serious type, that is called midbrain tremor. It is a very serious type of tremor. It is characterized by combination of the rest, even in the postural and action tremor, which is often severely disabling and very hard to treat. Okay, if you go to this image, damage to the region of the red nucleus, you can find over here. Okay, and typically it's seen in the head trauma or vascular insult. Okay. This is very difficult to treat, and prognosis of this type of tremor is very difficult, okay, and very poor. Eighth one, it is dystonic type of tremor. In the clinical features, you find that tremor occurs in individually all the ages who are affected by the dystonia. Okay, it is irregular, asynchronous, and usually affect the arm and the neck. Right, it occurs irregularly. On often can be relieved by complete rest given to the patient. Okay, it's seen in the most common all type of dystonic patients. Right. Now, next very important part is the diagnosis. Okay, please read it very carefully how to diagnose a tremor. First, go to the first patient comes to you with the tremor. So, how to diagnose individual tremor one by one? If the tremor is physiologic, the answer is yes. Okay, then you should evaluate for the anxiety, caffeine use, serum glucose level, LFT or thyroid stimulating hormone level. Okay, if the tremor is not physiologic, then you should ask check for the if a patient taking medication associated with tremor. If it is a medication associated tremor, then it is called drug induced tremor. Then there should be trial of the medications and try for that, stop the medications. If it is no, then it should be relieved with the distraction. It is not relieving with the distraction, yeah, then you should go out and think for the organic cause. But if it is relieving with the distraction, then it may be the psychogenic tremor. And you should contact mental health evaluator or mental health counselor. If it is not relieving with the distraction, then you should go for think of the organic causes. What will the organic causes? If it is after the thinking about organic cause, if any organ is damaged, then you should think about first is the age of the patient. If the age of the patient is less than 40 years, yes, then you should go for the serum cellulose plasmin level and 24 hours urine copper secretion. If it is positive, then it is a Wilson disease, then you should need to give chelation therapy. If it is negative, then you should think about the neurogenic signs and symptoms. If the neurogenic signs and symptoms are present, then various anatomic, metabolic and genetic problems may be associated with this. Then you should go for the appropriate blood and genetic test with or without head imaging as per requirement. If it is no neurogenic signs and symptoms, then it may be likely essential tremor. Okay, then you should try for the beta blocker. Fine. If the patient age is greater than 40 years, greater than equal to 40 years, okay, then you should check for the rest or action tremor. If it is a resting tremor, then you should check for this type of symptoms, rigidity, bradykinesia and postural instability. If they are present, it may be Parkinsonism type of tremor, you should try for the dopaminergic agents. If it is not having this associated problem, it may be possible Parkinsonism in future. Please monitor the patient for some few days or months for developing these symptoms. If it is an action type of tremor, then there should be the history of alcoholism. If it is a history of alcoholism, it is called withdrawal or alcohol tremor, alcoholism type of tremor. If it is no history of alcoholism, it may be the postural or intestinal tremor. If it is a postural tremor, then it must be the ascending tremor. Try for the beta blocker. If it is not a postural tremor, intestinal tremor, then it may be the cerebellar tremor. Okay, and you should go for the head imaging for the stroke, mass or multiple sclerosis. Right, so this is the how you diagnose, differential diagnosis of the all the type of tremors. Okay, this is very important to go through all this chart, then you can come to know step by step which type of tremor it is. Right. Treatment. Now the treatment part. What are treatment available? The first one is the behavior therapy, then the medical and the surgical. So behavior therapy, it includes, we give the physiotherapy, in that we includes relaxation technique, stress management, using the less reducible hand to write or eat, we compensate with that, or using the weight. Okay, we give the treatment in order to reduce the tremors. Medical tremor. Okay, using the weight also, it is, behavior therapy also includes the weight bearing exercises also. Okay, that helps to reduce the tremors. The medical management includes the propranolol, benzodiazepines, gabapentins, botulinum toxin injection for the tremorogenic muscles. Okay, if it's not relieved with these two, then you should go for the surgical treatment, that is a contracted thalamectomy or DBS. So in summary, tremor is a very common and disabling symptom that is associated with the large number of neurological disorders that you have already gone through. Tremors can be classified into resting or action tremor. Tremor can be diagnosed based on the history, some type of tremor, okay. And number of the medical, surgical and physical treatments are available for the tremor, right. Yeah, these are the references and thank you all. Thank you very much for listening to this lecture. For any doubt, you can contact me on my YouTube channel, Dr. Dhvanisha. I am working as an interim principal at GPC Surat. Okay, and you can contact me, you can leave me comment on my YouTube channel. Thank you very much.